Food processing facility sanitation is an integral part of good manufacturing practices. Effective sanitation aids in ensuring the wholesomeness, safety, and quality of shell eggs. The negative impacts on food safety and egg quality are a result of microbial growth. Research has shown that ineffective cleaning and sanitation practices or programs can lead to reduced quality duration or potential product contamination. Residual microorganisms can lead to egg spoilage or foodborne illness. Most of this training series will focus on the United States Department of Agriculture Agricultural Marketing Service pre-operational sanitation inspection expectations. However, remember that the Food and Drug Administration has oversight of consumer shell eggs in the United States, as stated in 21 CFR 117. Additionally, customers, accrediting organizations, such as Safe Quality Food, British Retail Consortium Global Standard, and others, as well as state and local regulatory agencies, may have additional facility sanitation expectations that can impact your facility. AMS sanitation requirements are meant to protect the integrity of the USDA grade mark by requiring additional sanitation expectations at facilities that utilize AMS voluntary grading services. To meet these goals, AMS inspectors will assess for voluntary grading program requirements during the pre-operational sanitation inspection and throughout processing operations by utilizing organoleptic inspection assessments. While AMS may review microbial test results as part of certain export programs, AMS does not conduct nor require swabbing or biological testing during routine sanitation assessments. So what is organoleptic inspection? Organoleptic inspection assessments include sight, smell, and touch. However, microbial growth will not always be seen, smelled, or felt. Critical areas are defined as equipment with potential surface contact with eggs or come in contact with wash water or air blown to dry the eggs. Non-critical areas are defined as areas that are not likely to imminently affect product quality. Non-critical does not mean it is not important. Non-critical unsatisfactory conditions should be addressed after the processing line has been started, unless unable to safely do so during processing.
In this module, the critical and non-critical areas of various removal systems present on the processing line will be identified and discussed. These systems will include chutes for removal of bloods, dirts, leakers, and severely cracked eggs, and recirculating conveyor systems for rewashing dirty or stained eggs. Additionally, examples will be used to illustrate the satisfactory and unsatisfactory condition of various components associated with egg removal systems. Egg processing facilities shall be thoroughly cleaned at the end of each operating day. The term reasonably clean is applied during the egg processing shift to indicate that equipment and processing areas are maintained with minimum egg meat accumulation. More explanation of these terms is presented in the introduction module. During this module, automated and manual egg removal systems will be presented. Specific manufacturers will be mentioned, not to promote or besmirch, merely to highlight egg removal systems unique to processing lines and how these systems are addressed during pre-operational sanitation inspections. All portions of egg removal systems must be available and accessible for assessment during pre-operational sanitation inspection. The removal systems must be cleaned each day prior to processing. In order for equipment cleanliness to be properly assessed, USDA Agriculture Marketing Service graders should be aware of the method and location where downgrade eggs or those with defects are removed. The various models of egg graders will remove downgrade eggs or those with defects at different locations on the machine. Even machines of the same model can be configured to remove eggs at alternate locations based on the design of the facility. Legacy processing equipment may utilize human detection for cracks, leakers, bloods, and dirts, also known as dirty eggs. This occurs in the candling booth. More information on the sanitation requirements of inline candling booths can be found in the Egg Quality Detection Systems module. Downgrade eggs or those with defects may be manually removed by the candling booth operator. These eggs may be placed directly on flats or in inedible containers. The platforms, chutes, and containers utilized for this process are non-critical items, but must be cleaned at the end of each processing day. Modern processing machines have the ability to detect and remove eggs from the processing line which have cracked shells and ruptured shell membranes, also known as leakers. Often, identified leakers are removed by the processing equipment before transfer. During pre-operational sanitation inspection, the leaker removal site must be assessed to ensure thorough cleaning. Units that remove internal egg defects, such as bloods and rots, may perform this removal either immediately after the transfer, before the first packing lane, or at the end of the machine, after the last packer lane. Unless removed manually from the processing line, dirty and stained eggs will either go to a packer lane or a dirty egg return line. This line allows for eggs identified by the dirt detection system to re-enter the egg washing process. The location of dirty egg return lines depends on equipment manufacturer and plant design. The common locations are the end of the carriage system after the last packer lane, between the transfer and first packer lane, before the transfer along the main processing line, and under the multi-drum on mobile graders. The dirty egg return belting and bumpers are critical since they come in contact with eggs destined for packaging, similar to the accumulator. More information on the accumulator can be found in the accumulator module. Shelves located in the candling booth are used for egg removal by storing undergrade eggs on flats. These shelves and the flats should be maintained in sanitary condition. Shelves seen in this booth are satisfactory finding in a non-critical area. Booths may also contain conveyor systems that feed into the dirty egg return line. The egg contact portions of these conveyor systems would be critical as they are reintroducing eggs back into the grading process. Chutes and containers used for removal of undergrade eggs from the candling booth are non-critical, but must be cleaned daily. The pipes we see in these shots have been satisfactorily cleaned. The inedible container is clean and has a clean liner in place. These shots illustrate satisfactory findings of non-critical areas. Automated leak removal will include a combination of a chute and collection bin before the transfer area of the machine. Here we see an example of how the chute deposits eggs into a collection bin. The leaking egg removal system must be cleaned thoroughly after each processing day. Here we see the collection bin after a thorough cleaning. The chute and bin appear to be satisfactorily clean of a non-critical area. However, upon a more thorough inspection of the chute, we see residual egg meat and debris on the internal portions of the chute. This would be an unsatisfactory finding of a non-critical area. The system that removes eggs with interior defects will often be located between the transfer and the first packer lane. This is where bloods, meats, and rots will be removed. On the left, we see that the exterior portion of this chute and the collection container appear to be satisfactorily clean. On the right, with closer inspection, we see the interior of the chute was not satisfactorily clean. Therefore, this is an unsatisfactory, non-critical finding. A full removal of the chute allows for a complete inspection, where large amounts of egg and egg meat remain in the system. This is an unsatisfactory finding of a non-critical component. Removal of this chute reveals a thoroughly cleaned, non-critical area with a satisfactory finding. Some units require exterior panels to be removed to allow for thorough inspection of egg removal chutes. Here we have a full view of the satisfactorily clean, non-critical interior defect removal chute. Dirty egg return systems are comprised of various styles and components. To not interfere with production, they are often elevated above the processing room floor. Daily inspection of these conveyors is necessary and should be performed in a thorough and safe manner. Depending on their height and location, rod-style conveyors may be effectively assessed from below, as you can see through the rods. Similarly, plastic cradle-style systems may allow for assessment from beneath depending on the style of the system. Trough-type systems with cloth belts do not provide for visual assessment from below and may require a platform or other equipment for assessment when raised. Temporary elevated platforms used in sanitation assessments should be designed to safely support personnel by reducing the risk of falling and preventing unstable conditions. Common ladders and stools not specifically designed for safety in the food processing environment should not be used for assessment. Facilities with overhead belting should work with AMS local supervisors to come up with a safe assessment method for their particular system, which could include utilizing cameras, video, and other assessment methods. On the rod-style dirty egg return conveyor, the rods and bumpers are critical as they come in contact with the eggs. The interior bracing, as well as any framing or motors, would be non-critical. Here we see all the critical and non-critical components to be thoroughly cleaned and to be a satisfactory finding. This shot has multiple unsatisfactory findings. FDA regulations require that processed eggs immediately be placed in a 45 degree Fahrenheit ambient temperature. Therefore, eggs cannot remain on the processing line between shifts. The non-critical bracing and skids seen in this picture have a buildup of dried egg meat. In addition, the critical rods in contact with the eggs have egg meat present. This is a critical, unsatisfactory finding and must be corrected before processing begins. Here we see that the critical bumpers and rods are satisfactorily clean, but there is residual egg meat on the non-critical structures of cross members and side railings. This would be an unsatisfactory finding in a non-critical area. As opposed to inclining conveyor lines, some dirt return systems use vertical elevators. These can be of various materials and designs. Egg contact areas of these conveyor are critical sanitation items. The plastic cradle system shown here is continuous from pickup, transport, and return, and can be assessed from underneath, at pickup points, and at return points. Other designs utilize a separate elevating system that transfers to the conveyor. This system appears to be clean and is satisfactory on a critical component. Residual egg meat and debris would be cause for an unsatisfactory finding in a critical area and would need to be corrected before processing begins. Trough-type systems generally utilize cloth belts to transport eggs. These systems, when elevated, cannot be assessed from below. AMS employees and plant supervision should speak with the AMS supervisor to determine safe and adequate assessment methods. The cloth belts are critical and must be cleaned and assessed daily. These systems are easily assessed when at or below eye level, as seen here. In addition to the upper portion of the cloth belt, the underside of the belt and the trough bed should be assessed for cleanliness. Cloth belts tend to have staining. Staining, in of itself, is not cause for an unsatisfactory finding. Slight fraying of the belt is also not cause for an unsatisfactory finding, unless it leads to excessive buildup of egg meat. The belt seen here has no observable loose debris or buildup of egg meat, although there are a few areas of bare metal. The surrounding framing is non-critical and is free of buildup and debris. Therefore, this is a satisfactory finding on the critical belt and non-critical framing. Here we see copious amounts of egg buildup on the cloth belt as well as on the trough and belt junction. Furthermore, the grease on the belt drive appears to have egg meat embedded. This would be an unsatisfactory, critical finding that must be corrected before startup. A small amount of excessive grease on the end of the pulley system is not cause for an unsatisfactory finding, as long as it does not contain egg meat or buildup of foreign material. The pulley wheel behind the blue bearing has buildup of egg meat and is a critical, unsatisfactory finding. This portion of the mechanism is critical since it comes in contact with the porous cloth belting. The debris seen on the motor casing, electrical conduit, bracing, and leg are unsatisfactory findings on non-critical areas and should be addressed after processing begins. There are many styles and configurations for egg removal systems. The same model of equipment within different plants may have very different egg removal points and designs. It is important to familiarize yourself with each egg processing system you encounter to ensure all egg removal systems are evaluated before processing begins each day. Keep in mind, in any system, egg contact areas and associated components are critical.